Hello everybody, I am your mentor Mohammad Tariq and we are going to begin with a new session of bricks. Here we will deal with the light bricks, meaning the light and weight bricks. Then we'll go through the manufacturing of the bricks according to the material that we use. As you already know that in factories we need to reduce the sound, and for that purpose to have a sound proof wall. So for that reason we need to have hollow bricks as well. So let's begin right away with the new session. So I welcome you to an entirely new session of bricks in which we'll be taking up the different types of material. Now we come to the manufacturing of the bricks, that is in according to the use of the material. The material that we are going to use in the manufacturing of the brick. As we are all well aware that clay is being used very often and there's a lot of shortage of clay, or in other words you can also say that wherever you dig out clay there is a depression zone formed over there, and that depression zone has to be filled up. So in order to avoid such circumstances it is very essential to find another way or another material to use for the construction purpose. Just to avoid the excavation in soil, or rather to reduce the excavation in soil, it is important that we use some other raw material. So now what are the different sorts of raw materials that we can use? So it is number one the fly ash brick, and the second thing is the sand lime bricks. Sand lime bricks is also known as calcium silicate bricks. From here we are able to create cement and cement concrete block. So now we come to the fire ash bricks. As you know, the word ash means the waste product that we get after burning of anything, that is the ash. So in this case we use the burning of coal. After the burning of the coal, the residue that is left in industries and the powerhouses for generating electricity, as long as the boiler fuse where we try and create a lot of pressure, that is steam pressure, and what we do is we add a bit of lime and cement. Lime and cement is added as a binding material. It binds the fly ash with the cement and the lime, and you can give it the required shape that we need. So this is the one that we need, and it is quite low in maintenance, and the surfaces are quite clear in it, the edges are clear, and even the government has been even encouraging in the usage of this fly ash. The only negative thing which can be of course avoided is the odor or the smell that comes up right in the beginning when we are using this thing, or the ash is new. And if you use a color base over it, that odor will of course fade away. So this is what we know about the fire ash of the bricks in brief. So here are the different sizes of bricks which I have shown over here, of fly ash bricks. As you will notice that the sizes are different. This has a different size, this has a different size, And because we add a binding material, and that binding material is of course cement and lime that we have added to it, so it can stay to the size to which we have molded it. As far as the soil was concerned or the clay was concerned, it had to be shaped well, and when we could shape it well, only then we could acquire the proper stage of the brick. So here we can have different shapes of brick. You can just have the stretcher part or the header part, as I have already mentioned in my previous video regarding the word stretcher and the header. So next we'll come down to the silicate bricks. Now we come to the silicate bricks. As you can see in the figure over here, we have different colors of bricks over here. So these are all silicate bricks, and they are of various colors. Now we'll just go through the bit of manufacturing in brief. So the manufacturing is done in an autoclave. What is an autoclave? An autoclave is a oven which has automatic setting of temperature in it. Now we need to add a bit of limestone to it, and of course the pigment that is required to be added to acquire the particular color, and prepared adding water in it. Now the chamber in which we prepare it, it has a very high steam pressure in it, which involves a higher cost, and they are quite perfect for construction material in the Nordic region. When we say the word Nordic climate, it means weather temperature is quite pleasant. Generally the temperature is mild and pleasant, and it is weatherproof, national and also dignified. Silicate bricks are perfect for building cleaning joint wall. So it's used for additional fishing and load bearing walls. When we are talking here about the load bearing means where you have the load. So when we refer to the load bearing wall, it means the walls on which the load is transmitted. Now I have used a term that is known as additional finishing. Now what does this additional finishing mean? This additional finishing is referring to the finishing that we provide as a plaster on the wall. It is also used in partition walls. Partition walls means a wall that is built between two rooms, which divides the two rooms and gives it adequate privacy for the user. Apart from this, it also provides an exterior lining. When you are talking about an exterior lining of a chimney, it means that the chimney is built in a way where it has an interior lining, and this is provided as an exterior lining for the chimney heads. Now we come to the technical parts of the silicate bricks. So as you can see over here, we have the compressive strength, the density. So in case of stone, rather in case of a brick, 105 kg per centimeter square. Now in the case of silicate bricks, it is, the grade is about M25, which is about 25 Newton per mm square. The density of the brick, meaning the weight per meter cube, is about 1850 to 1950 kg. Then it is fire resistant and non-combustible. It does not catch fire. It is fire resistant. Combustible means firing it up. It doesn't burn. It can bear heavy loads. It is even weather and fire resistant. Then we have a very important factor, that is the noise insulation index. So here we have a slight correction in the PPT. The noise insulation index for silicate brick is 52 decibel, and for one stone wall it is 56 decibels. The half stone wall is about 48 decibels, and about the 1/4 stone wall is about 44 decibels. You must have gone through this in acoustics of a building. Now, even we have the shrinkage. The shrinkage meaning when something dries up, the volume reduces. When the volume reduces, it means it is shrinking. So that shrinkage is about 0.2 to 0.04 mm square. That is about 4.4 mm per meter square. So if you take it out, it is 0.4 divided by a meter. So you get the shrinkage strength of it. Then we have the bending strength. The bending strength is about 4 to 5 Newton per mm square. So this is all that we have in the silicate bricks. Next we will get down to the concrete hollow blocks, and along with that we will first be dealing with the interlocking tiles, which is quite phenomenal nowadays, which is nowadays quite common and is being used in regular basis for footpaths and in road construction also. Even in your localities you must be seeing it. So we'll just go through them also, and with the pros and cons of both of them. So that's it for your silicate bricks. That's it for the bricks, the fly ash bricks and the silicate bricks. In the next video on YouTube, I will show you the making of bricks by machine, and we'll go through that video. It will be also made by automatic machines and manual machines, and then we'll follow up your tiles part also and complete this bricks part entirely.